In this video, we will be designing XOR gate using transmission gate. So here is a schematic of how to design an XOR gate using transmission gate. After a few minutes, we will be understanding how to allocate these variables for inputs and as well as the control signals. So here we very well know the truth table for a simple XOR gate. It is the same. We have two inputs. A and B will be having combination 00, 01, 10 and 11. The combination for our consideration, we have taken it as B and A. We can also take it as A and B. Based on it, the input assignments might vary. So right now, we are considering it as B and A. No issues if you interchange that also. You can design by interchanging. That is also correct. So now, we have four combinations 00, 01, 10 and 11. In order to allocate input and as well as control signal, we are trying to club two rows together, where in the first row we have a commonality where we have both B as 00. So in order to know the variable, what we are going to do, we are clubbing two rows together where we have two different rows, row number 1, row number 2, but the values in both the rows under the column B are common. In order to club and understand which variable to write in your input and as well as control signal, we are doing a small alteration in this table where instead of zeros in the column B, we will replace zeros by B bar. It is given here. Similarly, in the column B, we have ones where all these ones will be replaced as B. So consider the column A, wherever we find 0, replace those two values by A bar. And 1 by A. This is what we have done here. Okay. Now, we know the output already. XOR gate is an inequality detector. Therefore, for the combination 0, 1, 1, 0, we will have the outputs to be 1. For combination where inputs are equal, A and B are equal, 0, 0 and 1, 1. For these two combinations, your output will be 0 and 0. So, I am retaining the same table as such for output Z. So, now, let us club these two together. So here when you consider these two combinations, B bar is common. And here we have to check what is an input, what is an output. B bar becomes a control signal. B and B bar is a control signal now. Whatever is in input A, we want it output Z. Look into the table, the first table. If it is 0 at A, the output is 0. If it is 1, again the output is 1. When this is happening, whenever the control signal B is equal to 0, whatever is in A should be carried to the output Z, that is 0 and 1. So now let us take these contents and put it in one particular transmission gate for these two rows. So look into the second table. We have the command B bar. We have the control signal B bar. So B bar should be given to NMOS transistor. So, B bar is given to NMOS transistor. So, what is the inverted signal of B bar? It is B. That should be given to PMOS transistor. Therefore, B bar to NMOS transistor, B to PMOS transistor. Therefore, allocating this control signal is over. Now, what happens? Whatever is in A is carried to the output Z. This is what our discussion is. So, therefore, our input should be A. Whatever in A, whether it may be 0 or 1, whenever this signal B bar is equal to 0, whatever is in A will be available at the output. This is what our assumption. Now, so first combination of clubbing these two rows together is over. We have assigned input variables and as well as control signals. Now, let us do it for the second transmission gate. In the same way, we are now going to club row 3 and row 4 together. So what happens in row 3 and row 4? Both the values are 1 and 1. That is, both are B. Whenever the control signal is B, we have to give this B as control signal to the NMOS transistor here. So what happens automatically? B bar becomes the other pair for PMOS. Let us see what the input is going to be. Okay. So when you consider these two, A and output Z, when it is A bar, actually it should be 0, but the output is 1. It is A. Actually it should be 1, the output is 0. That is what replicated in the first table. 0 means 1, 1 means 0. What does it mean? The output contains the inverted values of A. That is, output contains values of A bar. Therefore, A bar will be the input signal. So now, whenever the condition B occurs, that is, B connected to NMOS transistor, therefore B bar connected to PMOS transistor, at that time we are going to give A bar. So when this transmission gate is enabled, whatever is in A will be shifted to the other side. Okay, so that is, inverted values of A will be shifted to the other side. This is one way of assigning these values. The other way is, we already know the XOR gate expression, which is nothing but A B bar plus A bar B. So consider this set first, A into B bar. So A into B bar, A will be the input signal, B bar will be at the NMOS transistor. What is the complementary version of B bar? It is B, that should be given to PMOS transistor. What is the other half of the expression? It is A bar B. A bar B. So A bar will be the input, B will be the control signal which is given to the NMOS transistor. So automatically the inverted value B bar should be given to the PMOS transistor. So what will be the output expression here? It should be A into B bar. On the other hand, for the second transmission gate, it should be A bar into B. When we connect these together, the output expression will be just added, A B bar plus A bar B. So this expression is similar to the expression of an XOR gate. So this is how we have to assign input variables and as well as control variables for an XOR gate. So now let us see the working by assigning zeros and ones and check whether these assignments are correct. We'll ensure that now. So for the first combination, the input should be 0 and 0. What is the expected output? It is 0. Let us verify that. So right now A should be equal to 0. So A is equal to 0. A bar is equal to 1. And what is B? B is equal to 0. B is equal to 0. Again B is equal to 0. What will be B bar? B bar will be equal to 1. So all these values are assigned now. So when will this transmission gate be switched on? When there is a 0 given to the PMOS transistor, 1 given to NMOS transistor, this transmission gate will be switched on, because this TG is a combination of a PMOS and an NMOS transistor. Both should be on. Then what happens when both the transistors are on? Whatever is an input will be transferred to the output. So right now when B bar is equal to 1, PMOS will be off. When B is equal to 0, NMOS will be off. Therefore, the overall TG2 will be off. Now only TG1 is switched on, because for an NMOS transistor I am giving 1, for PMOS I am giving 0. Therefore, this transistor is on. A was assigned to 0. Right now I will have 0 here. Therefore, Z will be equal to 0. So Z is equal to 0. Next combination, A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0. So A is equal to 1, therefore A bar will be equal to 0. What is B? B is equal to 0. B is equal to 0. Again B is equal to 0. B bar equal to 1. Because B is 0, therefore B bar will be 1. Now which transmission gate will be switched on? 1 is given to a PMOS transistor. So this is going to be off. 0 is given to an NMOS transistor. Therefore the whole TG will be switched off. On the other hand, the upper one, TG1, is receiving 0 to the PMOS, 1 to the NMOS. So this TG should be on. What is the present in the input? A is equal to 1. That should be here. So therefore, your output will be equal to 1. Let's verify in the truth table. For this combination of A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0, output is 1. Now the third combination, A is equal to 0, B equal to 1. So A is equal to 0, therefore A bar will be automatically 1. What is B? B is 1, therefore B is equal to 1, here B is equal to 1, therefore B bar will be equal to 0. Now let us check whether this TG1 will switch on or not. Now PMOS is fed with 1, NMOS is fed with 0, automatically this TG will be switched off. What about the second case? B bar is equal to 0, therefore PMOS is given with 0, NMOS is given with 1, Therefore, this TJ will be switched on. If it is switched on, whatever in its input will be transferred to the output. What is it there in its input? A bar, which is equal to 1. So here it will be 1, therefore Z will be equal to 1. It is correct. In the fourth case, A is equal to 1, therefore A is equal to 1, A bar equal to 0. B is also equal to 1, B is equal to 1, B is equal to 1, therefore B bar is 0. Now which TJ will be switched on? What about the first one? 1 is fed to PMOS, 0 to NMOS. So this is going to be switched off. So 0 is fed to PMOS, 1 to NMOS. Therefore this TJ will be switched on. When this transmission gate is switched on, whatever is in input will be transferred to the output. What is in its input? 0. Therefore Z will be equal to 0. And the truth table also, Z is 0. I hope the complete explanation of designing, assigning variables and verifying the functionality of an XOR gate designed using transmission gate is clear. Thank you so much for watching the video.